Three Special Forces soldiers have been wounded in Afghanistan. They suffered fragmentation wounds during an operation in Uruzgan Province last week. The ADF says a number of insurgents were killed, including a mid-level commander. All three soldiers are expected to return to duty soon. So far this year, 14 personnel have been wounded in Afghanistan. A small Queensland community is in shock after a burnt-out and headless body was found by the side of a road. Firefighters made the grisly discovery when putting out a small grass fire near Gympie. Police won't comment on reports the body is also missing limbs.
We shocked the neighbourhood. The phones were ringing and everyone was just so shocked that it could happen so close.
Police are appealing to witnesses who might have been in the area yesterday afternoon. A man has been charged with 25 counts of child abuse in relation to the pogo stick death of a 7-year-old boy in Sydney's south. Police allege the 29-year-old man also produced child abuse material. The boy died in a house in May, members of the family claiming he'd fallen off a pogo stick and hit his head. An elderly man's been found dead in his burnt-out Adelaide home. Neighbours say he'd lived in the house for more than four decades. Investigators are still determining the cause, but the victim is known to have been reliant on kerosene heaters instead of electricity. A passing police patrol alerted firefighters to the blaze. Victorian detectives have revealed their investigation into a multi-million dollar soccer match-fixing ring is developing by the hour. Four Southern Stars players, the club's coach and the syndicate's alleged bigwig, Jerry Subramanian, faced the Melbourne Magistrates Court today. Investigators claim to have found more than $200,000 worth of income receipts since June. Jerry Subramanian's bail application will be heard on Tuesday. Apple is hoping its new range of iPhones, launched today here in Australia, will boost its market share. Hundreds queued at Apple stores to be the first to get their hands on the flagship iPhone 5S and the cheaper 5C, which comes in a range of colours. The selling point of the 5S is its controversial fingerprint technology. First through the door at Apple's biggest Australian store here in Sydney was Jimmy Gunnerman.
I'm waiting for iPhone 5S. Since midday yesterday.
It hasn't all been smooth sailing for Apple though. Customers have been venting on social media about technical difficulties after downloading the latest software for their existing iPhones and iPads. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 23 degrees in Townsville, 20 in Brisbane, 14 in Sydney, 11 in Melbourne, 13 in Adelaide and 14 degrees in Perth.